Later that day, Sandy was preparing to leave Sodor.
I am ever so sorry about what happened, Sandy.
Oh, Edward, don't worry about it.
No, but Sandy, it isn't fair. You came here as a guest, and look at the way you were treated.
But, Edward, we have to look at the bright side. At least I won't be trapped in a glass prison in the museum.
There's going to be a big Christmas party here tonight. But how are we going to get excited and enjoy it after what's happened?
Now, Edward, you listen to me. Christmas is sacred. It only comes once a year, and you must enjoy it as much as you can. So I do not want to hear any of that. Now, do you promise me that you will enjoy tonight's party?
I'll try. Goodbye, Edward.
Then Sandy left. Just as the fat controller came out,
Baller, I missed him!
That's the end of Sandy.
But there was more trouble, and the fat controller was worried.
Edward, we have a problem. There's something wrong with the generator at the power plant, and the electricity has went off all around the island.
Oh, Baller! What are we going to do, sir?
I don't know. There's a special part we need to fix it. I don't know if we're going to be able to get it in time. First Sandy and now this.
You know something, sir? I'm more upset about what happened to Sandy than I am about this power cut. You know, it doesn't matter if Sandy really was from the North Pole or not.
But there was one thing we had to do, and that was believe he was from the North Pole. Because if we believed he was, then he was. And if we didn't believe, then we didn't.
What do you mean, Edward?
Well, put it like this, sir. In God, we trust.
The fat controller gasped in shock.
Oh, Edward, that's it! That's it! You are right!
Soon what Edward said spread all over the island. I'll believe. I believe. I believe.
I believe. I believe. I believe. I believe.
I get it now. How silly have we been? I guess I believe as well.
So do I. I have been very stupid. I believe. I believe.
I guess I believe as well.
So do I. I believe too.
Do you believe? Do I believe? Why not? I believe. I always believed.
I believe.
I guess I believe too.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe. Oh, I suppose I believe too.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe. And I never stopped believing.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe. I believe as well.
The manager went to Noob's shed.
Where's Banger and Peggy?
Oh, they've went to greet Sandy Claus.
It was very kind of you, Noob, to suggest that he can stay at this shed until a museum is found for him.
Don't mention it, sir. It was no problem whatsoever. Now go home. It is Christmas Eve, of course.
Oh, I guess it is, Noob. Oh, see you after the holidays, and Merry Christmas!
Oh, Merry Christmas to you too, sir. At the sheds, Thomas was upset.
Poor Sandy. He didn't deserve that, Daisy.
I know, Thomas, but I swear, I tried all I could to stop Diesel. And I have to take a special part to the power plant. I hope it fixes the generator, because if it doesn't, Sodor will be in darkness. And a dark Christmas, too. Oh, this is terrible. I am serious about this. If I could go to the mainland now and bring Sandy back, I would.
Daisy's driver overheard.
What if that is possible?
Well, what do you mean?
What I'm saying is, it is Christmas Eve, and not many trains would be running tonight, so what if we arrange with a signalman to go to where Sandy is and bring him back?
Oh, driver! That would be brilliant!
Oh, that would be wonderful! Everyone is sorry about what happened to Sandy and I, so they would all welcome him back in open arms. And if Sandy was here, it would make Christmas great again, even if it will be in darkness.
But we will need help. Diesels.
Diesels?
Diesels? But sir, that would be impossible. Sandy will not come back if he thinks that Diesel hits him. So we're going to have to try to convince Diesel that what he did on Sandy was wrong. And then he must come to the mainland with us and bring Sandy back.
Can we do it, driver?
We'll have a try. I will take you to Diesel's shed at once.
Mr. Kennedy had a similar idea. Then his son came out.
Where are you going, father?
Oh, son, I'm just... Well, what Diesel did is wrong, and I know where Sandy is, so I'm going to try to convince him to help bring Sandy back.
Guess what, father?
What is it, son?
I'm coming with you.
Oh, no, son, you can't.
Now listen, father. Sandy made me a better person. Before I spoke to him, I was a spoiled brat. And I now know the true meaning of Christmas and getting presents. And it is why I'm going to give someone a present of my own.
But son, you've never bought anyone a Christmas present in your whole life.
Well, times have changed. Now father, do you know where that young boy lives? The one that's Muller is a cleaner in Knapford Station.
Why, sonna, yes I do.
Well, we must go there first. He only has an Xbox, and I have bought him a game.
Oh, son, he will be delighted. We will go there at once.
Thomas brought the special part to the power plant. The wax diesel was there as well. They were both hoping that the generator would be fixed. Meanwhile, Mr. Kennedy drove his son to the little boy's house. So he wrapped the door and left the present. Then he ran back into the car. When the little boy came out, he was surprised.
Mommy, it's a present! It must be from Santa Claus!
Oh, son, I am very pleased, said his mother.
Thank you, Santa, he shouted.
The fat controller spoke to the engines.
The generator is still not fixed. If it's not fixed in time, we'll not be able to have the Christmas party.
All the engines were very sad.
Daisy rushed to Diesel's shed.
Diesel, come on! We must go!
Go? Go where?
To bring back Sandy!
You mean you want me to go to the mainland on Christmas Eve night to bring back an engine that I went through a lot of trouble to get rid of? No chance.
But Diesel, you were wrong. You used him, and you used me, just to get an overhaul. Now you must put things right. Please, Diesel.
If you want them back so much, go to the mainland yourself and bring them back. I don't care.
But Diesel, he won't come back if he knows you don't want him. You're the reason that he's gone, so if you ask him to come back, then he will. Please, Diesel.
But Daisy, wasn't it the Flying Scotsman that declared that he wasn't the Santa Claus's engine?
Excuse me, Diesel. I don't know much about this. But wasn't things going just fine until yesterday?
when you publicly humiliated that engine at Knapford Station and made him out to be mad. And then you even turned everyone against him.
No offense, Dart, but is this really any of your business? You spend all your life in that diesel works.
Well, is it really any of your business, Diesel, whether that engine believes that he's Santa Claus or not? Oh, but wait. It's nothing to do with that, is it? The real reason was to make you popular with the people, so you could get your precious overhaul.
Just then, Mr. Kennedy and his son arrived.
Right, Diesel, I found out where Sandy is. Now you caused this mess, and you're going to put it right, so we're going to the mainland, and you're going to tell him that you were wrong.
No! You all are stupid! You all think I only done this because I wanted an overhaul. That was part of the reason. The other reason was, he got on my nerves, going around the line, ho ho ho, ho ho ho, all the time. He thought he was something. That engine is bigger than his wheels.
Mr. Kennedy's son spoke severely to Diesel.
Now listen here, you. Before I met Sandy, I was selfish and spoilt. But now, I know the true meaning of Christmas and getting things and appreciating them. It was Sandy that showed me that. And another thing, if you believe that he's from the North Pole, then he is. If you don't, well, he isn't. Come on, Diesel, believe.
Diesel had a face like a wet weekend. He was cross.
Let me tell you something, little boy. I was okay. I wasn't in pain all the time. It only started from the springtime. And that was when the mallard pushed me off that track and I was laying in that ditch for a couple of weeks. And I was repaired, but haven't been the same since. And the most upsetting part of all, when everyone thought I was dead, they were probably glad.
That is nonsense, Diesel!
We all grieved for you!
Every engine on this island! Everyone was upset!
Really?
Of course! You were the first Diesel on this railway! Never forget that, Diesel! Tell me something else! Why have you never asked the Fat Controller for an overhaul, seeing you need it so much?
Because he would probably scrap me. Would it not be cheaper to buy a brand new diesel than get me overhauled?
But you're no ordinary diesel. Don't forget, you were the first diesel on this railway, as I said. And you were in the Railway Series.
Yeah, and many others.
But you had your own book, Duck and the Diesel Engine. Remember?
I suppose.
Please, Diesel, believe in Sandy and come with me and bring him back.
Okay, what are we waiting for? We'll bring him back.
Do you mean it, Diesel?
Of course, I'm in pain and I was taken out on everyone. And poor Sandy suffered because of me. And I was desperate to get fixed. And I'm gonna show Sandy how sorry I am. Daisy? Mr. Kennedy? Let's go!
So Mr. Kennedy and Daisy's driver got things ready. Soon they were racing through Sodor.
We are bringing him back!
Shouted Daisy.
Oh, it's Clanky! What brilliant news!
I suppose it is. Thomas and the Works Diesel were still at the power plant. The generator still hadn't been fixed. Soon Daisy and Diesel were in the mainland.
Where are they going in such a hurry?
Banger and Peggy were with Sandy at Bow and Furnace. Suddenly, Daisy and Diesel arrived.
Hello?
Who are you two?
We're here for Sandy. We're bringing him back to Sodor.
But you don't understand. Noob is waiting for him.
I'm sorry, but it's all been arranged. Sandy will stay here until a museum is found for him.
Listen, we made a mistake, and we're here to bring him back.
Aren't you that diesel that declared him mad?
Listen, everyone that was questioning Sandy has changed their minds. We want him back.
Did the Flying Scotsman change his mind?
No, the Flying Scotsman. I forgot about him.
The Flying Scotsman is here!
Flying Scotsman!
Oh my! It's the famous Flying Scotsman!
I thought you hated LNER engines.
Oh, I do. I forgot.
The engine will return to Sodor at once!
Oh, I'm ever so sorry. But it's all been arranged. The engine stays here.
Well, it'll all be on arranged then. The engine is coming back to Sodor.
Then Sandy's driver came out. What exactly is going on? Are we returning or are we not? It is Christmas Eve after all.
I don't know. Am I really wanted back on Sodor?
Sandy, listen to me. All them things I done in you, I apologize. I was using you to get what I wanted.
Oh, Diesel, what did you want?
Sure, I wanted an overhaul.
Well, when we get back to Sodor, I will speak to Sir Topham Hatt about this overhaul.
You mean you're coming back?
Of course I am coming back.
Great.
Now what are we gonna do?
Back in Sodor, the most amazing thing happened.
The engines cheered.
The power is back on. So the Christmas party is not cancelled. Let's go to Knapford Station at once.
But little did they all know that Sandy was returning to Sodor.
Noob, let me introduce you to Sandy.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!
But it looks like banger.
Ho, ho, ho!
It sounds like banger.
Ho, ho, ho!
It smells like banger.
Really? Does it?
Do you think I'm some sort of idiot? It is banger! Where is Sandy?
Well, you see, the diesel sent him away, was sorry, and came and brought him back with the Flying Scotsman.
No! No!
Ho, ho, ho.
Banger. I believe.
Peggy, I believe as well.
When all the engines went to Knapford Station, they had a shock.
Sandy! Shouted Thomas.
Sandy had returned. Everyone was happy.
Oh, Sandy, are we glad to see you, smiled the Fat Controller.
It is marvelous to be back.
Can I have your attention, please? Today, I made a mistake, so I hereby announce that Sandy is the engine of Santa Claus and lives in the North Pole.
Sandy smiled.
Excuse me, Sir Topham, but that diesel of yours has been in awful pain lately, and I suggest that he needs an overhaul. And he was scared to ask you, and that's why he went about the way he did.
Everyone, what I've put you all through these past couple of days is unforgivable, and I just want to say that I am sorry.
Diesel, why didn't you tell me you were in pain?
Because I'm a common shunting diesel, and I thought you wouldn't have wanted to fix me.
Well, Diesel, you thought wrong. You will get your overhaul after the holidays.
Diesel was delighted. Then all the engines enjoyed the rest of the Christmas party.
This has turned out to be the best Christmas ever!
And everyone agreed.